In the long history of military aviation, few moments have truly shaken the global order. One such moment was when Russia, amidst economic pressure and political isolation, suddenly introduced a mysterious figure, the Sukhoi Su-75. Checkmate, a fighter jet claimed to be capable of rivaling and even defeating the US-made F-35, Lightning II at a third of the price. But behind this aircraft's emergence lies a far more complex story than just a military project. It is a manifestation of Russia's ambition, strategy, and high stakes in re-challenging Western dominance in the air. In the modern world of defense, air superiority is not just about military might, but also a symbol of technological and economic supremacy. For decades, the United States has held near absolute control of the world skies through jets like the F-22 Raptor and F-35 Lightning II. Russia, on the other hand, struggled to maintain its reputation after the collapse of the Soviet Union with increasingly limited resources. But out of that slump was born an ambitious idea that took the world by storm, the Su-75 Checkmate. The project first appeared publicly in 2021 amidst a hostile global environment for the Russian defense industry. Economic sanctions, limited access to Western electronic components, and political pressure made many believe Russia would be unlikely to launch a new fifth-generation jet. But precisely at that moment, Sukhoi unveiled a mysterious prototype with a futuristic, stealthy design, a silent message to the world that Moscow had not given up. Shortly after its unveiling at the Max Air Show, Russia brought the Checkmate to the international stage at the 2021 Dubai Air Show. This move was not only symbolic, but also strategic. The Middle East is a major global arms market, and by showcasing this aircraft there, Russia wants to demonstrate that it still has something to offer the world. The Checkmate is a symbol of Russia's resistance to global economic pressures and a reminder that its defense industry remains viable. The name Checkmate is no coincidence. It's derived from a term used in the game of chess, a game that has long been a part of Russian culture and is often used as a metaphor for geopolitical strategy. In chess, checkmate means a decisive move that kills an opponent, signaling total victory. By naming this Checkmate, Russia seems to be conveying its readiness for a surprise move that could shake Western dominance in the air. But the message behind the name is much deeper. Russia knows it cannot outperform the United States economically, let alone technologically, in the short term. Therefore, it has chosen a different strategy, not competing with power, but with efficiency and price. Checkmate is not designed to replace the F-35, but to appeal to markets that cannot afford or are not permitted to purchase the F-35 at a price of around US$25 million to $30 million per unit. Russia is selling more than just an aircraft. It is selling strategic independence to countries seeking air power without relying on the United States or NATO. Symbolically, the name Checkmate reflects Russia's long-term strategy in global geopolitics. It is not seeking to win an outright war, but rather to position itself to change the course of the game. Unlike the highly complex twin-engine Su-57 Felon, the Su-75 features a single-engine design. This seemingly simple move is at the heart of the Checkmate philosophy: maximum efficiency while maintaining high capability. With a single engine, production and maintenance costs can be drastically reduced, allowing Russia to offer a competitive price without sacrificing basic performance. In terms of appearance, the Checkmate has a stealthy shape with an S-shaped air intake, a V-shaped tail, and delta wings, creating a highly aerodynamic appearance. This design helps reduce its radar cross-section, making it difficult to detect by enemy radar. An internal weapons bay allows for missiles to be stored without compromising stealth, while a new generation avionics system and AESA radar promise broader detection capabilities and high precision. Russia claims the Checkmate is capable of reaching speeds of up to Mach 1.8, has an operational range of approximately 2,800 kilometers, and can carry up to 7 tons of weapons. Furthermore, Sukhoi announced plans to integrate artificial intelligence, AI, to assist pilots in maneuvering, target selection, and rapid decision-making in aerial combat. If realized, this would be a major leap forward for Russian fighter jets, which have historically relied more on physical strength and extreme maneuvers than complex digital systems. Russia has never hidden its intention that the Su-75 is an export project. With a limited domestic market and military budgets consumed by ground warfare, exports are key to the project's survival. Countries such as the United Arab Emirates, India, Vietnam, and even Argentina have been mentioned as potential buyers. Sukhoi promises that the aircraft will not only be affordable, but also flexible. It can be tailored to the needs of the user country. The Checkmate is also being developed in several variants: a two-seat version for training and drone coordination, and an unmanned version for future high-risk operations. This approach demonstrates that Russia is thinking not only about conventional air warfare, but also about the era of network-centric warfare, where fighter jets, drones, and defense systems are integrated into a single data network. For Russia, the Checkmate is more than just an industrial project, it is a tool of technological diplomacy. By offering a more affordable fifth-generation jet, Russia is seeking to expand its influence among countries seeking to build modern air forces without political pressure from the West. In other words, the Checkmate is both an economic and geopolitical weapon. The future of the Su-75 remains uncertain. Will it truly reach mass production, or will it simply become a beautiful chapter in the history of Russian ambition? With the rapid development of sixth-generation jets like the American Ingad and the British-Japanese-Italian Tempest, the Checkmate risks being left behind before it has a chance to prove itself. On the other hand, if Russia does succeed in producing it and bringing it to the export market, the impact could be enormous. The Su-75 has the potential to shake up the global defense market and force the West to rethink its export strategy. The Checkmate may not defeat the F-35 on the battlefield, but it could beat it in the political and economic game. And that's the true meaning of its name, Checkmate, a strategic move not always won by force, but by cunning and timing. The Su-75 may still be a vision, not yet in the skies, and likely has a long way to go before it becomes a reality. However, in the modern military world, ideas and symbols are sometimes more powerful than bullets. Checkmate has become a symbol of Russia's determination to remain on the global chessboard, where every move, no matter how small, can alter the balance of power. And as long as the world looks to the skies, Russia will continue to strive to prove one thing: that the fight for air dominance is not over. And perhaps, amid all this uncertainty, Checkmate is Russia's boldest move yet.